Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In part 2 on expression animation in Flame, you learnt about channel hierarchy, which enables you to drive the animation of one object off the animation of another object in the composite. You also learnt about evaluation and selection order, which helped you determine the value of an expression at a certain point in time, as well as offsetting the timings of that animation over a specific set number of frames. In part 3, you'll carry on with evaluations, but this time you'll be introduced to random generator functions, as well as have a good play with the mathematics to fine-tune the generators. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the description below. Alternatively, if you're watching the podcast, then please type the displayed link in your web browser. Now load the batch setup and go into this action node with the 2UP view using Alt-2. In this example, if you play or scrub the composite, you can see that we have some bouncing text which is animated by an expression placed on its kerning channel. You can check that out in your own time, but what we really want to focus on in this video is looking at random value generators. In other applications, you might call this the wiggle. So to finish off this composite, we are going to add an expression to the 3D light to make it flicker in the composite. For starters, double-click the light in the action schematic. Holding down Shift, click the intensity slider to select it. You'll use this channel to create the flicker effect. Switch to the animation editor, and the intensity channel is selected and waiting to be animated. Press the close square bracket to open the expression editor, or press the expressions button. The first random generator you'll use is called the rand function. Type rand, open bracket, frame, close bracket, and press enter. The definition of this expression is generate a random value every frame. If you press the frame button, you'll see the curve generating a random value every single frame. However, the image is black. The reason for this is that the random generators generate values between minus 1 and 1. Now, since the default light intensity is 100, the random values are nowhere near that. So we need to multiply and increase these random values. Open the expressions editor and type times 10. Press enter. The height of the curve grows, and you can frame the curve to fit the window. Scrubbing the composite, there are small traces of light, but the value now sits between minus 10 and 10. Anything below 0 is black. Now we would like to create a mild flickering, so you need to raise the entire curve into positive values to make more use of the random generator. Open the expressions editor, and after the times 10, type plus 100. Press enter and frame the curve again. So the generator gives us a value that is multiplied by 10, and then 100 is added to that value. So the random values now occur between 90 and 110 in the intensity channel. This happens at every frame, and the curve has shifted up, making the flicker more usable in terms of its brightness. Now, two issues still remain. Firstly, using the rand expression in its current state is generating a new value every frame. This is creating quite a fast flicker, which appears too disturbing, so you may want to slow it down. In order to do that, you need to introduce evaluation into the expression, which gives you more control over time. For example, let's update the random value every 5 frames instead of each frame. So open the expression editor and go to the beginning of the expression. Type eval, open bracket. Next, go to the end of the line and place a comma after the 100, and this defines the value portion of evaluation. For the time portion of evaluation, press space and type frame. If you left this as it was, you would still be generating a value per frame. To slow the update to every 5 frames, type divided by 5 after frame. Close the bracket and press enter. Now the value updates every 5 frames in the curve, and scrubbing the composite, the result is less stressful to the eye. Finally, the last remaining issue is that the value is changing at a constant. So one random value is not flowing into another. It's like switching a light on and off instead of slowly dimming it up or down. This is the outcome of the rand function. If you want sloped curves between random values, you need to use a different random generator. Open the expression editor and let's change the function. Instead of using the rand function, we'll use the noise function. Just substitute the text and press enter. The curve changes once more, and now you have a naturally flowing curve. With all the maths in the expression, this curve sits between 90 and 110, and the random value updates every 5 frames. However, instead of instantly changing value, the values gradually adjust for a more natural result. There is much more you can tweak and play with, and please check out the online documentation for the list of other random generator functions in Flame. Now, what if you wanted to manually edit this curve, but currently it is derived from an expression? In the next video, you'll learn how to take this mathematically generated curve and turn it into a keyframed curve that you can manually edit and fine-tune. Please subscribe for updates to the Flame Learning channel, and comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thanks for watching.